Well, g'day guys, it's Ian from Aussie Tech. Yes, me again. But yeah, of course, I'm back again because I got a really cool video to do. And I'm doing it with this rig. And what you can see here is a GoPro Hero Black, and the DJI Osmo Pocket, the brand new one. Pocket's up there, it's actually not a brand new one. And the DJI Osmo Action. Similar names. Anyway, I'm going to be doing some side-by-sides with the GoPro Hero 7 Black and the Osmo Action, and I'm just throwing in a little bit of there with the Osmo there pocket, just to see the difference in quality. So yeah, I'm taking these out to have a bit of a play with, just a brief little look. I'll do some more detailed videos over the next couple of weeks and stay tuned for a review. But today I'm just going to be looking at a quick image quality difference between and stabilization difference between the Hero 7 Black with its hyper smooth, and the DJI Osmo Action with its rock steady. And we'll throw in some video there from the DJI Osmo Pocket, just to see the difference with a proper gimbal compared to the electronic stabilization. Let's take these out and have some fun. So there you go, there's some video footage with it, some side by side with the GoPro Hero 7 Black. I wasn't too happy with the image yesterday, but after playing with it a bit more today and I've already been home and checked the footage from the Hero 7 Black and the action, I'm a lot happy with it today. Question mark over low light, I'm going to test a little bit more of that tonight. The one area I'm not still completely sold on, well that's a nice car, is Rocksteady. Now we all know that Hypersmooth on the GoPro Hero 7 is really good and it's almost gimbal like, but the footage that I've seen so far beside each other when I've been walking slowly, not doing the ninja walk or anything like that, but I do feel at this stage when doing the walking videos that the GoPro Hero 7 is actually a little bit better. Again, I need to do some more practice. I need to use the camera a bit more. These are just my initial impressions on this camera. I really like it. I like the color science. The color, especially for skin tones and that, is a little bit better on the GoPro. On the action. I like having the selfie screen so I can face myself. Even though it does turn off, it's still good to be able to line yourself up when you start recording. But yeah, overall, I'm pretty good. It's gonna be a really good vlogging camera. Gonna do some more side-by-side testing tomorrow with the Hero Black, and maybe even tonight. Might be going into the city to get some low light testing, because that's one area that I was really impressed with, the Osmo Pocket, but this doesn't seem as good. I thought it would be just as good, because they're saying it's basically the same sensor. So there must be some differences with the lens, because obviously the lens on the Osmo is less fisheye, so maybe that allows more light in. I don't know. I don't know what the f-stop is for this lens compared to that. So we'll be doing some testing on that tonight, because it's an area normally the GoPro Hero 7 kind of really falls apart in its low light, so it'll be interesting to see there. Action cameras aren't really designed for low light, they're such a small sensor. So overall, I'm pretty happy with it. Got some buts about the Rocksteady stabilization at this moment, and I have checked and made sure that it's on, because there's been a lot of videos where people haven't got it on, so I don't know. I need some more playing around. This is just my initial impressions. Wait for my Osmo review to get more detailed information on that. So there you go. Hope you guys have all enjoyed. I'm Ian, this is Isaac Tech. Catch you guys later. Bye!